I thank you for joining me. I'm going to be reading the Earth Class Notes, written by the 12th Apostle, entitled Hatred. This word, hatred, communicates a soul sin, and nothing justifies hatred. Love is the most powerful force there is in the expanding universe and is the cause of God creating the universe, whereas hate caused Lucifer to change the visible universe to what we still see today. The greatest written comparative analogy of this is when Jesus prayed from his crucifixion, "Father, forgive them, for they know not what they do." That all four of the gospel writers wrote, that great love is why it did not all end then. Don't think it was all planned to be that way, for that is a major deception that many have fallen prey to. Jesus taught this truth so well, "And ye shall be hated of all men for my name's sake." Luke 21:17. Also, in verses 36 of the same chapter, Dr. Luke wrote that Jesus taught so plainly, "Watch ye therefore and pray always, that ye may be accounted worthy to escape all these things that shall come to pass, and to stand before the Son of Man." Meaning you proving in your attitude and actions if it really is true with you. As you know, love is not an emotion or how you feel about someone or something, and is certainly not lust, but requires the total action of the entire 12 unlimited abilities of our soul through understanding and knowledge and belief of proven truth that sets us free to love God most of all, then Jesus, then others, including all angels, without any fear whatsoever. It is written, "There is no fear in love, for perfect love casteth out fear, because fear hath torment. He that feareth is not made perfect in love." 1 John 4:18. An example of this is in the Old Testament with the life of Samuel, who was promised to God before his birth by his mother Hannah. Samuel's mother made him a tiny coat each year. "My mother made my very little clothes on an old foot peddling sewing machine, as she taught me about God and Jesus," which was much more than Samuel was taught, as his mortal life on earth was over 1,000 years before Jesus was born. Eli was the priest in the temple where Hannah had left young Samuel to learn from the high priest. Eli was a very poor priest and even worse teacher, as he never taught and even disciplined his two sons, and even let the light of the fire go out and the Holy of Holies, where the Ark of the Covenant was kept. And that was a very low time in Israel's history. All of this was one reason Israel had asked Samuel to anoint a king over them instead of truly seeking the love and guidance of God. They even cast lots and gambled for who their king would be. But I should explain one reason why the other tribes of Jacob, whose name was changed to Israel, had an inherited dislike for the tribe of Benjamin, because Jacob blamed Benjamin somewhat for the wife he loved the most, Rachel, who died at Benjamin's birth. Before Benjamin's birth, Jacob had thought Joseph was dead, as Jacob's 10 other sons had staged his death, even showing Jacob his bloodstained coat of many colors that Jacob had made for Joseph, for he loved Joseph more than his other sons, who resented that, and they had sold Joseph to some Ishmaelite traders for 20 pieces of silver, who sold him in Egypt. But God used Joseph's genius abilities to take all of Jacob's family through 7 years of famine in the land, as Joseph had progressed second only to the Pharaoh in Egypt, where the children of Israel multiplied very fast in Egypt. When that Pharaoh in Egypt died, the next Pharaoh did not have the same love and appreciation for the Israelites there, and began to force many into hard labor, Whereupon the more intellectual Israelites left Egypt, going north and west, settling England and in the British Isles. Jesus bypassed all of the rhetoric and got right to the point when he taught, "Thou shalt love the Lord thy God with all thy heart, with all thy soul, and with all thy mind. This is the first and greatest commandment, and the second is like unto it. Thou shalt love thy neighbor," meaning all human souls on earth, "as thyself. On these two commandments hang all the law and the prophets." Matthew 22:37-40. Remember that perfect love casteth out all fear. He that feareth is not made perfect in love. 1 John 4:18. Fear and hate are major deterrents to love and all spiritual progress. Beloved, this is our classroom. May we learn and may we love. Thank you so much for your time. Until next time.